Hey guys, today I'm going to show you how to change your CV joint. It's going to be right there. But the first thing first, what you want to do is take off the tire and go ahead and hit the subscribe button to help me help you. And this, my next video could be your next problem, the next car you're working on. So help me help you, all right? And it's going to be 19 millimeter to take off the tire. Alright, so what I'm gonna do in here is take off this the tire end. It's gonna be 18 millimeter, and I'm also gonna take off this right here and push this down so I can get room to take out the CV axle. Alright. And this, I'm gonna take it out from here. See if I can take it out now. It's coming, it's almost there. All right, so that should give me room to move everything. And this, I'm gonna take this off. The axle nut, which gonna be 36 millimeter. Take that off, all right? That's off a little bit. You want to knock it free up. All right. As you can see, it's free up. Now it's time to take off the tire then. All right, the tire then is off. Let's see if I can get closer. Take off the tire then. I'm just gonna put this here so I don't lose it. And also now it's time to take off the bolt that holds the ball joint. Alright, so you wanna take out that, and that's gonna be 16 millimeter. So on the other end is going to be a E14 reverse torque. Alright. Take that out. Let's just pull down on it and see if it moves. So now you want to pull hard on it. Get it out, alright? Alright, so now I'm going to have to use like a extended bar. Push it through here. Push it under here. Back so you can see what I'm talking about. Alright. So hopefully you can see. Because I have this off so I can move the steering wheel this way. Whatever.
see, like that. Now it's time to take out the seeds.
Hope you guys see that, but that's how I take it out. Alright, so when you follow the CV joint, you're gonna see like a plate that's holding it, like a bracket. So you're gonna need to take out those two bolts that you've seen. They're gonna be 13 millimeter, and also you can push this back. There's one down there, and it's also gonna be 13 millimeter too. All right. Let me see if I can get it so you can see it. And then I get this one down here. Okay, now they all loose out. So now I'm just gonna take them out. That needs to come out some more. And this one down here, I can take that one out. Alright, so now it's all loose. So now it's time to go underneath there and pull from underneath there, alright? Alright, so this right here is the CV joint, CV axle. So what you want to do is hold it on both hands and you want to shake it and pull it towards, take it up. That one is very easy to change. All right, so this is the new one right here, as you can see, and this is the old one. Alright, you just want to put them side by side and make sure everything line up. And this is the bracket that I was taking off with those three 13 millimeter bolts. So just so you can get a good look at it, what to look for. And also I had set this here just in case any transmission fluid come out, but none didn't come out, so it's here. Alright, so now it's time to go back. Now when you're putting it, when you're putting it back in, you gotta make sure this is at the top. Alright, where the two bolts go, gonna be at the top. Alright, so you wanna strip down your CV axle from now. Strip down, I mean take off your nut and take off this from this one. Alright, time to put it back up. Alright, so make sure this is up. Go and let that, alright? And when you you're putting it in, make sure you monitor the bracket, because if you get hooked like right here, it's gonna stop it from going. So you gotta put it in and monitor this, line it up correct so you don't get hooked on anything. All right, it's time to catch the bolt and then put this part in the spindle. Alright, so I catch all my bolts. Got two at the top, one at the bottom. I'm gonna go ahead and tighten them up. So I'll try to catch the one at the bottom here. Alright, so you want to go ahead and tighten it up.
Easy. You want to spin it, make sure it falls in the grooves.
Alright, so I want to catch that like that, and also you want to set this like that, and you can spray WD-40 in it to make it a little bit easier. Alright, I'm going to try it first without the WD-40 on it.
Just want to shake it and knock it at the same time, alright?
And it will go in really easy. And now you want to catch back your bolt and nut that hold the lower ball joint. That's nice and tight. Now it's time to catch back your
Faraday.
That's nice and tight, and that's nice and tight right here. So both of these are done. This one, you want to get back the rubber, put it back in here. All right. So you don't want to use an impact gun to tighten down your bearings. You want to make sure you bring it down with it a little bit, and then use a torque wrench or a power breaker bar to tighten it. And after that, you want to lock it. So this is what I mean when I said lock it. You want to hit this down, hit that down in there, and this point you want to double check your work, make sure everything is tight. Those are tight over there for sure, this is tight for sure, and this is tight for sure, and this is tight. So now it's time to put back your tire on. Put on your tires. All right. And that's how you do the front, the right front CV joint or CV axle. And I'm gonna do the left side next. All right. So stay tuned for that video. Go ahead and hit the like and subscribe. All right.